This is Eileen Smith, and coming up, we're going to talk about Facebook Timeline for Pages. They just rolled out Facebook profile timelines. And I just wanted to share a quick tip with you because this is a little counterintuitive to what we normally think about Facebook. Hey, and by the way, this video is the second video in Barry Wells's Internet Marketing Challenge. So today is March the 4th, 2012. They just rolled out these profiles for our pages the other day. And the first thing that you might notice, I don't have a like option here, and I'll show you why. Let's go over to the Starbucks page. Starbucks has one of the most engaged pages on Facebook than anyone. And I don't like the Starbucks page, not because I don't like Starbucks, but because I really don't drink coffee. I probably should like the page though, because I do love their turkey sandwiches. Anyway, see this like, this is the thing that I am telling you guys, get rid of it. You see why? When I click this, I still didn't like the page. I'd have to come up here and click like again. But look at what I get. I find out all these stats. Now, do I care about their stats? No, not really. But look at this. I see that they've had some of their worst performance ever as of late. And even with all these changes, they went back up a little, but they're nowhere near where they were back at the beginning of February. Do you really want your new Facebook fans seeing these stats? Of course, it's not our fault that engagement has fell off for pages. It's Facebook's fault. And yes, it is showing us our friends who like the page, but isn't it much more important to have one of our other tabs here? Like for me, I want people to go to my YouTube channel. I want people to watch my podcast or sign up for my email list. So since we have limited amount of real estate here, this one you can't change. And real quickly, let me show you how to change it. All you need to do is click here. And that little pencil will come up. And this is where you swap the position. So I've already swapped it for my YouTube, but if you wanted to swap here and put a different app there, that's what you would do. Okay, so that's a quick tip. Like I said, I know it's counterintuitive, but this is where people can like your page. Let me go back to Starbucks. There's already a like button over here. So you don't need this thing, which is even bigger, cluttering up your valuable real estate here. So, hey, I got another quick little tip I want to give you. And before I even give you the tip, I have to give a big shout out to Easy Street Social. They subscribed to my YouTube channel today. So I said, let me go check out some of their videos. And they had a Facebook timeline video tip that I'm going to share with you right now. When you're logged in as your profile, go over to your Facebook page, okay? I'm logged in as my profile, but I'm on my page. You have access to the admin panel, even when you're behaving as a profile. What I really like, and this tip, and I'm telling you, I've been on all kinds of Facebook webinars since this change, and Easy Street Social are the only ones who showed me this tip, and that's why I'm sharing it with you. You get to see all your likes, and this gives you an opportunity to go and make friends with the people that have liked your page. Before, you couldn't do that. You'd have to, you know, you'd have to do this whole big convoluted process in order to get back to the profile of your new likes. But now you have to do is click right on them. Then you could go ahead and send that person a friend request or just subscribe to them if you just want to subscribe to them. Hey, thanks for watching this video today, and this is an excellent time for you to go up and subscribe to my channel. And it's a Miss Eileen Speaks channel or over on YouTube. Hey, give this video a thumbs up or leave me a comment. And I'll see you again here or over on basicblogtips.com. Once again, it's Eileen signing off. Peace.